Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we will cover procedures. So the agenda is, what is a procedure, why we use it, and how many different type of procedures we have. So we have in-stream procedure, then we have catalog procedure, and then we have nested procedures. So we'll cover each one of them in detail. So first we'll start with, what is a procedure? So it's a set of statements grouped together to perform a particular function. Suppose if in a procedure you have coded one part and you want to call that, then that can be done from JCL. So it can be in two ways, which we'll discuss later. So it can be included any JCL by calling the procedure. So in the exact statement, you need to write proc is equal to the proc name, procedure name, and it does not have a job statement because they are dependent on the JCLs. It cannot be directly executed. We cannot directly submit a procedure because it does not have a job statement. So now we'll then see this in-stream procedure. So in-stream procedures are located in the same job. In the job itself, we first declare them and then we use it. The catch here is, first you need to define it before calling the procedure. If you call a procedure and it is not defined before that step, then it will throw an error saying procedure is not found. So this is the how we declare a procedure. So you need to write proc name. Here you can choose any name, the procedure name, then the keyword is proc. Then you can write any statement here, and then pend. So pend statement is used to mark the end of the procedure. It means like procedure ends here. So, and it should be defined before calling the procedure. So now we'll see what is a catalog procedure. So catalog procedures, they are coded outside the job. So in in-stream procedure, you have done all the coding itself in the procedure, but in case of catalog procedure, you need to code it outside in any PDS, and that PDS you need to define in the JCL lib, which we have covered in libraries, because if you don't define JCL lib, it will say procedure not found. So, and in this, pend statement is not mandatory. You don't need to mark the end because it's just a single member in which our statements are present, and it can have maximum 255 steps. So now we will see what is nested procedures. So calling a procedure from other procedure is a nested procedure. So like if we can invoke an in-stream procedure from another in-stream procedure, and it can be up to level 15. So now let's see all these functions practically.
We will start with in-stream procedure. I have coded one JCL to show how to call an in-stream procedure. So this is the JCL, edit, reset. This is the job statement. Now here we are defining the in-stream procedure. As discussed, the syntax is, you need to write the name here, name of the procedure, then you need to write the keyword proc, and from here onwards you need to write the steps. These set of statements will be copied when we will call this in-stream procedure. I will show you that. So here we are calling a program 1, which is present at this location. And pend is used to end off an in-stream procedure. It is used to mark end of an in-stream procedure. Then in the next step, we are calling the defined in-stream procedure. We have defined TP proc and we are calling it in this step 2. So I will submit this. Here you can see condition code 0. Now we'll go to spool and check the output. Status of jobs, ST. So this is our job. I figured it out by seeing the job ID. This is the latest one, 1126. We'll see how the JCL is converted. In our JCL, we have coded only the definition and then we call the procedure. So while calling procedure, it added the steps. Here you can see plus plus sign. So it has copied whatever statement were present in the definition. So step 1 exec program 1 step lib and then the print statement. So when we executed it, executed the program 1. We'll see the output of program 1. Go to sysout. Here you can see instream procedure. It's a COBOL module in which I have written instream procedure, only a display statement, nothing else. So F9. Now we'll start with catalog procedure. Catalog procedure is coded outside a job. I have created one PDS, proc. You can see this tutorial.point.proc. In this, I have coded one catalog procedure. Here, I have defined the name of the procedure, cat proc, then proc, the keyword. Then we have called program 2. These are the statements. In catalog procedure, you do not need to mention pend, which is used to end the procedure. So simply define it here in the first line, name it, mention the keyword proc. After that, mention the set of statements which you want inside a catalog proc. So we'll call this proc from our JCL. I'm going to JCL. I've coded jproc for that. In this JCL, I have given the JCL lib library. In previous video, you have seen JCL lib is used to provide the path of catalog procedures. So we have given tutorial.point.proc and here we are calling proc catproc. So when we will submit this, all the statements present in catproc will be added after this step. So we'll see now, submit. So it is successful, maxcc is equal to 0. We'll go to spool F9. Here you can see our job, catproc. We'll see the JCL. In this, we have coded only one line. I'll show you here. Call catproc. And above in JCL, we have mentioned the PDS of proc. So it added all these lines, the catalog procedure definition, catalog procedure, and then the statements. And it executed program 2, which is present in the load library. Now we'll see the output. So it is saying catalog procedure. In the program 2, I have displayed one statement, catalog procedure. Now we'll see nested procedures. Catalog and instream procedures can invoke other procedures. So we'll invoke one catalog procedure from an instream procedure. This is our member nested, J nested. Reset. Here we have given the JCL lib, which is used to provide the path for catalog procedure. Then we have defined an instream procedure. What we did is, in the instream procedure, we have called one catalog procedure. Here you can see catproc, which we called in our previous module. And then we are calling the in-stream procedure. So when the JCL will be executed, first it will copy the steps of catproc here, because we are calling this in-stream procedure, and then the catalog procedure contents, like catalog procedure statements, will be printed here, and it will be called from this in-stream procedure. So it will be more clear when we'll see the spool. So I'm submitting it. Condition code 0. We'll go to spool F9, F3. This is nested one. So in our JCL, first we have declared one in-stream procedure. Then in this step, we have called the in-stream procedure. And in in-stream procedure, we are calling catproc. So what it did is, it first called the in-stream procedure. And in in-stream procedure, then it added the steps for the catalog procedure. Here in catalog procedure, we have mentioned program 2, the library, and the sysprint. F3. It executed program 2 in which catalog procedure was written. So we called one catalog procedure from the in-stream procedure. This is all about procedures. In the next video, we'll cover overriding parameters, which are used to override parameters inside the proc.